What's going on, friends and family? My name is Skylent, and today I'm going to be talking about why I'm stupid excited for the new Smash Ultimate, and why I'm going to be streaming it nonstop over at twitch.tv/Skylent, but especially December 7th. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, friends and family, please go to twitch.tv/Skylent. Follow, and if you want to use your free Amazon Prime, Twitch Prime subscribe, please do, and come and support, well, the family. Support the channel, because if you want this community to grow, and if you want me to keep my energy and keep up my daily pace of content creation, the best way to do that is probably going to be through Twitch. Of course, you know, there's Patreon. Of course, you can just straight up donate. Of course, you can always try to promote the YouTube videos. But frankly, Twitch is just going to be the better, healthier platform for me. And I think it's really exciting to start this new platform and then jump into an entirely new genre of game and type of stream with Nintendo community and also the platform fighter genre here with Smash. And really, I'm just jumping into the fighting game community as a whole. So a whole lot of firsts, a whole lot of news, a whole lot of new faces and places to see. And I'm just excited about all that. So first and foremost, why am I excited for Smash? It's going to have to be from the respect of community. It's all new people, all new experiences, and that includes local tournaments, right? Because this is a competitive game, and as an MMO player, I did not really get that. I don't know if you noticed this, but the most social genre on the planet, MMOs, well, they're online, and they have to be played online. And so you don't get that face-to-face stuff. You don't have that many events and festivals. You can claim Comic-Con, but that doesn't count. BlizzCon, no, it's not MMO specific. You don't go to play the MMO, really. It's not the same, right? So I missed out on like local fighting game tournaments and esport events, and I've only just now started going to esport events. My first one was actually Overwatch. And back in the day when I was in high school, I actually started up a Rock Band tournament that became annual at my high school, and I loved that. But since then, I was so out of touch. I didn't really go to much. It was just a couple years ago, I went to a Needhog tournament. I came in like fourth, but yeah, I mean, that was shitty. It was played on a projector, but it was kind of fun still, regardless. I've been to very, very little actual events, and I think with Smash, like, duh, there's gonna be tons of it. There's gonna be local stuff, there's gonna be like grand finals, it's gonna be at Evo, and even if I can't be competitive, it's still something brand new to me that I can live stream IRL, that I can just constantly and consistently play and take seriously and digest and divulge its secrets as I become better. And even then, just as a critic, as a casual player, I think I can do a lot of fun content. And I think it's gonna be fun. You can interact with me, actually. It's one of those games that is both competitive and casual. So if you want a 1v1 me, you what, mate? Let's get it. That was so fun when we did that in BDO and For Honor especially. I really appreciated that. Thank you guys. I love playing with you all the time. So even casually, party games. A couple of times, we jump into battle royales. We shoot the shit and we play silly stuff. So I like it, that's cool. But no, especially online party games. A couple of you guys helped me with some reviews. IO games, it's been a blast. And Smash is just a game where it can always, even if I'm not, like if it's not the number one game on my channel, it can always sit at the B side, the B track to my playlist for Twitch. You know, we could be playing some hardcore, you know, scrims or whatever in Fortnite, and I'll be like, all right, boys, let's go Smash. Anytime, anywhere. It's just, I feel like it's a game, and literally, actually, on the Switch portable, I can play it anywhere. So I'm super excited to get out in the world and then also bring you guys into my world and play with me. That's what it's all about. You think I just start the video every time with, hey, friends and family, just for shits and giggles? You think it's because I'm trying to foster a community? That's really for me. I want you guys. I want friends and I want family. I want closeness. I want community. That's why I play online games specifically, and that's why I started my channel doing MMOs. Of course, that was always lacking. There was always something lacking there. And I've been going to different genres, and I've been trying different stuff. Indie games, fighting games. I've got top 10 free-to-play fighting game list that came out, if you guys want to watch that. I've got Platform Fighter coming out. So excited for that. And there's a lot of content and a lot of stuff I want to do. And you know what? Smash is kind of like spiraled throughout all that goodness that I want to try and all that I want to do, especially with this new direction where I'm heavily focusing on Twitch. And just real quick, to end the first part of this video where I'm like, hey, I'm excited for Smash because of the community aspects and because of the meta, you know, hey, I'm a content creator aspect. I just want to say I am heavily focusing on Twitch. And frankly, Smash is going to be a great game to stream. It's going to be fun for me. It's going to be fun for you. You can join in. I can join you. It's going to be great. That's that. We're going to do the do. It's going to be sweet. So that's it for that. I'm going hard on Twitch 6 hours a day. It's going to be fantastic. At least Monday through Friday, or, you know, 5 days a week. That's happening. Okay. So next, why am I super excited about Smash? Well, the thing is everyone's ready to smash on Smash. December 7th, man, when this drops, whenever it drops, hopefully midnight or something for East Coast, it's, the world is gonna catch on fire. That's something that a lot of people don't like. They'll detriment a conversation by saying, well, it doesn't matter if a game is popular. Well, actually, a game like Smash, a fighting game, yo, it does matter if a game is popular. It really does, in a number of different ways. That's a whole different rant. But I'm just saying, I am excited because I'm brand new to this community and there's gonna be a million billion. Okay, there actually might be like a billion new people. The Switch is super popular. So there's gonna be a bunch of new people playing this game. There's gonna be a bunch of returning players. It's like everyone's gonna be experiencing this together. And of course, also again, as a content creator, as a streamer, that's just something special. But in the end, you have to realize everyone is a critic and everyone is a content creator. Everyone is going to be making blog posts, Facebook posts, you know, everyone's going to be talking about it with their friends, sharing videos, streaming it. Everyone is going to be talking about this game together and playing this game together. And that makes a difference. That makes a game way more hype, literally, and exciting to actually physically play and be a part of. And I really want that too. All right, but yeah, the meat and taters of why people are excited about this game. The thing is I have played a few other platform fighters, and definitely enough to be ready to be qualified to do a top 10 platformer fighter list, which is coming pretty soon. Except I just still need to play Smash. The thing is that even as someone who's never played Smash, right? I've only played it very rarely, lightly. I played a few other platform fighters, but like I can instantly tell that this next game, through the advertisements, through the streams, which, you know, for the past year, I have just been devouring all the content for this game. You can tell that there is love and heart in this. You can tell that this is going to be a big thing. They would have to royally sabotage kamikaze this for it to not be amazing, basically. And in the end, just all that's going into this game. Literally, I mean, it's Smash Ultimate. Everybody's here. And then we got extra DLC characters coming, which is why it's $100 freaking dollars. This game is just going, I think it's just going to work. I think I'm very, very hopeful. And I say keep the hype alive, and I try to hype up videos. I am an influencer after all. But often I will say don't pre-order or don't get your hopes up or stay critical. And I will definitely dagger this game every opportunity I get. But the thing is I'm very certain that this is going to be a good game. You know, just actually going off of player testimonials after all the testing that they've done with the game, all the promotional material. And also, this isn't just like the first game in the series. No, this is tried, tested, and true, right? So after all this time, it's been maturing, and here we have now the ultimate form of debatably one of the best games of all time. It's probably gonna be quite impactful for this generation of gamers, especially the new ones, the younger ones, getting the Switch, getting Smash. You know, brothers and sisters are gonna make enemies out of each other. Fathers and mothers gonna hate each other and love each other. This game is gonna bring out the best and worst out of everyone, and it's gonna be awesome. I cannot wait. But yeah, in final finality, I guess, I just wanna say that this is something new to me. I am somebody who plays games competitively, seriously. Overwatch, I jump to Masters, and a lot of MOBAs, I jump in, I climb right up the ranks, except for League, because that game's hard. But I do play some games casually, it seems. I play party games, I play mobile games, but every time I play any game, I always take it super seriously. It's just, that's how I have fun with games. And Smash is something that is totally new to me. It's a whole new mountain to climb with a spectacular view at the top, I'm certain of it. And I wanna see all the shapes and colors and taste the flavors that this game has to offer, because I have no idea. All these very radically different characters, this strange way to play a game, being a platform fighter, and I'm used to playing MMOs, right? So it's like MMOs are totally horizontal. This game's totally vertical. What? it's such an alien thing for me. And even though I'm gonna try to sport the eSport, even though I'm gonna try to be a sweaty and a try hard, just know that is me having fun. That is me as a child with wide-eyed wonder looking at this entirely new adventure ahead of me, which is daunting. It's scary, especially since I'm gonna be streaming and I'm gonna be trying to take it myself seriously. I'm trying to take the game seriously, and it's all so silly and cheesy, I understand. But it's like this as a whole everything that I'm doing, this movement from to the Switch, playing Nintendo games, playing more casual co-op-y PvE games, and then also at the same time competitive fighting games like Soul Calibur, stuff like that, and moving it to Twitch, and you know, taking more time with the games and trying to be serious with them, and then you know, playing this game that I'm it's all new, it's so scary, but it's kind of like, you know, that first jump. It's like that first jump off of the rail bridge. I don't know. When I was 18, I actually jumped off a really tall rail bridge into a pond, and that was scary as hell. But it was super fun, and I don't regret it. I'm glad I didn't die. But here we go. I'm taking that risk once again. Hopefully the reward is worth it. I'm taking the plunge. I'm jumping off the bridge. That could be taken wrong, but like, you know, I'm taking the jump. I'm going on that adventure. Climbing the mountain. There's some danger involved. You know, who knows? Hopefully you guys can support me on Twitch. Hopefully you guys can have fun and play with me on, you know, the Switch, on Smash. Hopefully as a community, we survive, because that's actually up for debate based on how YouTube pays me and probably based on the tidal wave of promoters who will overshadow me. But, you know, as a small content creator who wants to actually engage the content, play it, and not just report on the news, you know, and do first impressions, somebody who really wants to play, I really hope you guys are there to play with me. It's scary, but, you know, let's go on this adventure together. Thanks for watching, guys. Much love, and hopefully I'll see you on December 7th.